Whenever I play Uncharted, I always think about how much physical strength it would actually take to do this shit. Hello everyone, it's part 4 of Uncharted Drake's Fortune. New recording session for me for the night. Shit, okay, we'll totally screw that up. I was reading the thing, and I'm like, okay, what does it want me to do? How am I supposed to do this? There's dudes right there, and I totally screwed it up. How's everybody doing? I just got out of work about, maybe 2 hours ago. And, I always work the weekends, and I don't work tomorrow. So I'm feeling good. You know, tomorrow's my day off. Just at home, playing some Uncharted. Today is the first snowfall in western New York, within the area that I'm in, which is close to Buffalo. Niagara Falls represent. So we got our first snowfall, and I need a long range weapon. I'm gonna go back and get my pistol, or my 9mm, whatever it was. What was it? Yep, 9mm. I'm gonna use this. Yeah, we got our first snowfall. I walked outside after work. And sure enough, there was snow on the ground, there was snow on my car, my brand new car, and I started to get a little upset. I got one small little tear ran down my face. Now granted, I'm born and raised here, you know, I'm proud of where I'm from, but I fucking hate the winter and I hate the snow. And then, just a few minutes ago, I was looking at, I was looking at, road tripping, and, road tripping to, the west side of America, obviously, California, because I love California. I love that state. I love visiting there. I love vacationing there. I get my tattoos done there. I love the sun. I'm all about it. I don't know, man. I just love California and LA and everything, so I was looking at, road tripping down there, and I was, reading some forums of people posting, saying, I'm gonna road trip, what should I do, where should I go, where should I stop, how much is it gonna cost me. I was just kind of researching it a little bit, not to say that I would actually do it. I mean, you know, if I had the time and money, I would totally do it, to be honest, because I'm all about experiences. I would so do it, but, obviously, I'm in no reasonably good position right now to do it, but, I would do it. Where am I supposed to go? There's stuff over here, isn't there? I can do stuff over here, can't I? Jeez, careful, Drake. I don't want you to die. Cough. Yeah, but so I want to mention straight up, if you hear some extra background noise, that's because I got my space heater. Like I said, snow. It's cold. It's cold here in western New York, so I got my space heater on right now, and it's blowing right on my feet. Which is awesome. My feet are super, super warm right now, but it is making noise, so I'm just letting you know right now. If you hear that extra background noise, that's what that is. I did unplug my air purifier, though, because I was not about to let that keep running while doing this Let's Play. Cause that'd be too much noise. I want that much noise. That's too much noise. That's why I said it's too much noise. Whoa! Don't look at me. Oh, really? I'm calling bullshit. Wow, dude. Some of these dudes are fucking troopers, man. They're taking shots right to the head, and they're just, really fine with it. They are, A-okay. Isn't there a gunner coming up over here? There he is. I was like, there's a mounted, gunner, turret over here. Not a turret, because a turret would imply that no one has to man it. But a gunner implies that it is still, a turret, but someone has to man it. See what I'm saying? Yeah, I think you guys see what I'm saying. Got an Uzi again. I'm gonna use this thing a lot more sparingly this time. Still haven't used my shotgun, though. Where's that other dude? There was a dude right there. Come on, dude, don't be a prick. I feel like I'm walking past stuff. There's stuff I could be exploring and looking at right now. Even though I have all the treasures in the game, so I really don't need to. We can just move right along. We can just move right along. But yeah, I was looking at the road trip thing, and I was really thinking to myself, man, I need to do more fun shit. Because the past, I'd say the past 3 years, I've really been all about work. I've just been working and working and working. And, you know, it pays off because I just recently bought a really nice car. And, I mean, you guys have all seen my room. I have, like, nice things in here. Like, I make enough, like, a decent amount of money to buy myself all the things I want and, of course, pay for the expenses of living because, you know, life does cost some money. So, you know, it's been pretty awesome. I can't complain, but I need to do more experiences because most of my time really is spent just, like, going to work, going to work, going to work. Days off, I try and play games, maybe try and hang out with a friend or two, but it is mostly work. So I'm really, like, I'm starting to think to myself, like, you know what, dude? This coming summer, like, I'm gonna try and do shit. Whoa, dude, chill. Don't do that. There we go. Why does it keep doing that every time? There we go. I'm gonna try and do some stuff. I don't even know, dude. I don't know. I'll go to the beach, maybe. I'm like ready now. Like, I'm keeping, like, a whoa, dude, chill. Oh, my God, are you fucking serious? Really? Really, dude? God damn it. Oh, and I'm all the way back here. That so would be the scenario that we're dealt with right now. Yeah, I'm thinking beach. I haven't gone to the beach in a while. I'm thinking all sorts of stuff. I really don't know. Canada, I mean, Canada's super close to me. And ironically, I haven't gone. I went, like, a long time ago, but need to get an enhanced license. Some people don't know what that is. If you, around here, you can get what's called an enhanced license. And basically what it is, it's a regular New York State license. But it allows you to go over the border easily. So if you don't have a passport, instead of buying like paying like, what is it, $100-$200 for a passport and going through the process of getting a passport, it's just something as simple as going to the DMV and spending like an extra $30 to get an enhanced license, and that lets you easily go over the Canadian border. And a lot of people here love having an enhanced and going to Canada because, well, first of all, the drinking age is lower in Canada, so people love going to Canada and getting shit-faced because they're, I don't know, like, losers, I guess? I don't know. I'm just kidding. I understand if you want to drink alcohol. It's not me, though. Yeah, but people love doing that, and then I believe you can also gamble there if you're younger. Although, don't quote me on that. And then, because there's a lot of casinos in Niagara Falls, Canada. Really? Yeah, that's not gonna hit him. And you can get a tattoo at 18, I believe, as well in Canada. So I think that's the appeal. But it's also just another, like, it's a whole other country. Like, it's a thing. Like, people go and do that. Like, they go out and have fun. Like, hey, let's go to Canada. Because it's literally right there. Like, I'm not shitting you when I say I can be in Canada in, like, 10 minutes right now from right in my house. If I got to my car and went to Canada, I could probably totally do it. Well, not now, because I don't have it enhanced, so. But the possibility is there. Assuming I get past the border. Border patrol. Why am I not immediately? Oh, there. Yeah, I'm going back here. Like, why is it not immediately clear where I have to go? Yeah, I could try and, like, maybe fight the border and get over, but I have a feeling that's not going to go over well for me. I was just down there. Where do I go? Over here, to the tower. Of course. Obviously. I think that puzzle's coming up soon. Yeah, but I need to get it enhanced, man. I'll go to Canada. I'll go to the beach. Go to the zoo. Go to the aquarium. I love fish. Maybe road trip to North Carolina or something. Go to New York City. Road trip to New York City. I got a friend that's out in New York City. Go see him. I just want to do stuff. Past 3 years, man. Nothing but work. I don't do anything. Yeah, there's Elena's, no sign of her. What do you call it? Parachute. Very good. Very bad. And we're gonna climb up here, right? Do-do-do-do-do. Yeah, something's about to happen. There's gotta be some sort of puzzle coming up. I remember a puzzle at some point. Oh, there she is. Filming. And then there's guy. And then there's guys coming. Hello? Buca Pinto. Buca Pinto. Like, that worked. It worked. There he is. How could he not realize that they were, like, just not gonna... Like, clearly it's him. Dude, they're fucking me up from down there. Jesus. Wait, whoa, where do I go? Oh, really? I don't want to waste my ammo I just got. Hey, that's a good gun I just got. There we go. Now I'll pick this the other one back up. Because the gun I just dropped is a one-hit kill. Where'd it go? Here it is, the Wes. Yeah, the Wes is a one-shot kill. I just don't have to... I can't mess, though, because that's a waste. Ah! Where? God damn it, and I missed. I missed twice. God. What a waste. I was gonna say something to you guys, but I forgot. Don't die. Thank you. Whoa! Screwed that guy up. Wham! Wham! See, guys, I'm good. Kind of. Man, imagine if I was playing on Crushing. Maybe for a Let's Play, I should play a game on the hardest difficulty, and you guys will see how incredibly difficult it would be for me to try and do a Let's Play while playing a game on the hardest difficulty. Because for in order for me to do that, like, I have to stay silent. Like, I have to be really focused. A lot of people ask, like, Ryan, how do you actually complete all these games on the hardest setting and whatnot, and how do you have so many platinums and all that? Like, when I shut the fuck up, I can actually, like, work. I can get shit done. Like, it's always when I'm talking or what do you call it? My attention is, like, gone. I have a short attention span. Okay, I only have a shotgun, so... Dude, the textures are not loading right now. This guy's gonna kill me, isn't he? Oh, get up there! Get in! Ah, no! Stop fucking inverting me. Not inverting, but changing the direction that I'm aiming. God. Ooh. Now, this is just like another shotgun. I don't need this. It replaces the shotgun. That's stupid. What's this? Yeah, I don't know. I don't want that. Yeah, I'll take this. I had nothing else. I think I need to grenade that this dude. Or I need to, yeah, I think I do need to grenade him or something. Ah, dude, chill. Chill, man. Chill. That's so come on, dude. Let's mess this up. Yeah, there we go. See, we're making progress. Hey, what are you guys up to? I'm realizing it's still a few weeks from this actually being posted. This is like 4 weeks out. And so we really can't talk about anything completely relevant. Like, I can't talk to you about Little Big Planet 3 because I haven't played it yet because it's not out yet. I know, I'm filming this early, but I have to. It just works out for me schedule-wise. Otherwise, I'm not going to have enough time to actually play Little Big Planet 3 and then film it. So I get all these Let's Plays done. It works out well for me. We've been over this a few times. We've been over this many times. Oh, I shot that guy in the dick. Cartman would still be upset with me. And that's actually one of the cool, the good things about the Ryan on Gaming series is that, like, a lot of people enjoy when I'm, like, in front of the camera and discussing, like, the industry or whatnot. And the good thing about those videos is they don't have to be entirely news-reliant. So with Let's Talk PlayStation, I've been over that before. Like, that's news. Like, I do it every Friday, and I record it every Thursday night. That's just about the gaming news. So with, certain nights, I can film a bunch of Ryan on Gamings on various topics. And then I can upload those over the course of certain weeks. I can also do that with the Remembering series, but I haven't done those in a while. I filmed a few of them, and then, like, I wasn't happy with them, so I just never uploaded them. And the reason why I wasn't happy with them was, I don't know, but for me, that's, I enjoy the idea of that series, and I made it, but, to me, it just, I don't know, some, it, I don't know. I'm very particular with the videos I make. Like, it needs to be, there needs to be some really good substance to it. And some of the remembering videos that I recorded just seemed like a circle jerk about how much like the game was good, but I didn't like add enough. I didn't say enough detail. Oh shit! I didn't say enough detailed things about it. I guess like I was like watching the I would film one. Oh Jesus, guy's fat. I would film one and then start editing it and playing it back and everything, and I just wasn't happy with how I was discussing it. Like, I didn't go over enough gameplay mechanics or something, or there was too many things that I forgot to touch on, or maybe there were criticisms I didn't touch on. Maybe I'm just too hard on myself, but I recorded a few of those and I was like, oh, I'm not happy with this, I'm not gonna release these. But I kept the footage, so I might just do the voiceover work again and try and really nail it. I really do try and get good shit out. Where do I go? Because I don't know. I'm lost. I think I need to be up here somehow. I don't know how, though. Okay, well, that was simple enough. But I still don't know how to get over there. Jump? I mean, it would have to be. And it is. But I can't get up on that ledge, so I'll just jump across from there. There we go. What's this? AK? I don't need that. Ah, it's so warm in here. It's awesome. Like, I don't even need a hoodie with this space heater. This thing's awesome, dude. This thing gets super hot. And I'm so fucking lazy. Like, I just prop my feet up on the desk and put the heater right before my feet, and I'm just like getting warmed on up. Where am I going? Another room where I don't know where to go. Oh, I'm yawning. It's a little late. Okay, well, I'm thinking these little divots in the wall might have something to do with it. Whenever I play Uncharted, I always think about how much physical strength it would actually take to do this shit. Like, when you really think about it and look at it, this would take a lot of physical strength to pull off leaping from ledge to ledge like that and actually holding on to them like that. Like, that would suck. It reminds me of the first time I watched Man vs. Wild with Bear Grylls. Like, when I started to really get into that show, I was tweeting to people like, dude, this guy is fucking Nathan Drake. He is literally, like, Nathan Drake. He's climbing on walls and shit. He's all about the wilderness, and he's killing it out here. But even then, I was watching him and making that full-on comparison to Nathan Drake, and I was like, even this guy can't really pull off the shit Drake does. Now, you may be saying to yourself, well, Ryan, this is a video game, and I understand that. And that's kind of the real reality of it, that this is a video game, so clearly I don't expect one real human being to pull off the things that Drake does, but it is interesting. Drake, why can't you get up? Thank you. I was going to say, why can't you get up? I'm clearly pushing up. Ooh, 6, unlocking the past. Love it. I love it. Look at this shit, man. Some dungeon. Dude, Drake looks so cool holding a shotgun, by the way. Okay, well, yeah, put it away, Drake. He looks so cool holding a shotgun. Drake's just cool in general. What is that? What is this on the table? I'll take it. Dude, I want to know what Uncharted 4's gameplay looks like. Maybe we'll know by the time this comes out, because the PlayStation Experience event will have happened by then. And apparently, there's going to be a lot of stuff going down at that PlayStation Experience event in Las Vegas, which I wish I could go to. I never really even discussed that. I think it was pretty obvious, like, I'm not going to be able to go. But, like, I would love to. Especially Las Vegas. I've never been to Vegas. I really want to go to Vegas. I would fucking love to go to Vegas. Mostly for, like, the restaurants and stuff. Gordon Ramsay's got this burger restaurant in Vegas, and I want to try it so bad. I watch videos of it on YouTube, of people going there, and I just I want to go so bad. It's called Gordon Ramsay's Burger. And, well, better believe they serve burgers. And I think I've been pretty vocal about the fact that burgers are, like, my favorite food. So I just really want to go. It looks unbelievable. I want the farm burger. The farm burger has, like, the meat is, like, there's three different types of meats in the patties. And then, like, who's shooting me? Stop, guys. Please stop. And then it's like there's a fried egg on it. It's like, I forget what type of cheese. I think it's on a brochet bun, though. But it looks delicious. I want to go. I'm gonna need one of you to stop shooting me. Actually, I'll take both of you, now that you mention it. Oh, I'm gonna shotgun this guy. He's not ready for it. Stop! Why does it keep doing that? Why? Why does it keep rotating that? Stop. I'm not clicking L3. I'm not. I guarantee you, viewers, I'm not doing it. Am I supposed to go back over here, by the way? I'm not entirely sure. I think I'm climbing this, aren't I? Oh, no. This thing over here. Aha! Aha! That reminds me of the professor in Spyro, Year of the Dragon. With Agent 9, the monkey. I should go back and watch that Let's Play. Because I mentioned that when I was actually at that professor. Like, I would always sit near that professor and I just, like, listen to him go, aha! Over and over again. He's so weird. Like, who does that? Don't do that. Fucking game NPC making the same noises over and over again. I know I have to, like, climb shit. I just don't know where to start. It's somewhere. Uh-oh. Wait, I can only look at it over here. All the keys. Oh, that's it! Yes, here's the puzzle thing. Shit. I don't know. I'm already lost. I'm sorry, guys, I failed you. Alright, I'm gonna go up here. Because this is clearly the starting point I've now figured out. Maybe I can actually get this done. Without the help of the internet. I was gonna say, is that a skull? But it was a seagull. I'm not making that jump, am I? Well, I guess I am. Okay, he's doing that. Oh, thanks, dick. Uh-oh. Yep, I pressed circle. I pressed it fast enough, too. So now we're up here. Get up. We're across the ledge. Oh, no! For a second, I thought he was gonna die. Yeah, you know, like games do that sometimes. Like, it's got a lot of platforming sections, and then because you've just reached a certain height, that when you start to fall from another, like, level, you'll die instantly, even though you are aware that that height difference actually isn't that big, so the game kills you automatically, simply because you've reached a sort of new level where the game starts to save a certain point. I hope anything I just said makes sense. It's hard to articulate what I'm thinking. If you can hear that noise, that's my rat scratching in his hammock. And then the rods of the hammock are connected to the, you know, the metal of the cage. Ah, what the dick? I'm supposed to jump, aren't I? And so when he scratches, it, makes like a noise. That noise, basically. Yeah, that's what I thought. You gotta climb this tower. Whoop. Oh, Drake, don't do that. You know, here's what I'll tell you guys. So we all know Podcast Beyond. I've been a fan of it for years. I think the first episode I listened to was episode 4. Not to be a hipster, but like I have been listening to it for a while. You know, Greg, Ryan Clements, Colin Moriarty and like Chris, even though the OGs, Chris Roper, Jeff Dunham, I love all of them. And one of my favorite episodes of, I'm actually not sure what to do right now. I wasn't paying attention. One of my favorite episodes of Podcast Beyond is episode, it's 72, and that's what I'm supposed to do. Yeah, excuse me, thank you. Okay, I got the keys. Now I just gotta leave, right? Yeah, down the rope, okay. I've got episode... So it's episode 70. I'm like, what am I even talking about anymore? Episode 72 is my favorite one. That's the one where they get a soundboard for Mr. T, and they act like Mr. T is actually in the room talking with them. So they're just playing these pre-cut sections of Mr. T, like, sayings, and they're actually responding back to him like he's a human. It's the funniest, I think it's the funniest fucking thing ever. Apparently people hated it back when it came out, like, fucking 4 years ago or something. And Greg hated it too, because Greg wasn't even on that episode. But I thought it was hilarious. I keep it on my phone all the time, and I always, like, I've listened to this hour-long podcast over and over and over again. It's, like, sickening. I just find it so funny. Like, like Mr. T would just be like, you better watch who you're pushing. And the guys go, whoa, okay, hold on, T. Hold on, T. Sorry, T. And the one T's like, and Mr. T's like, you got a problem with that? No, sir, not at all. And then at one point, somebody, I think it was Jeff Haynes, said like, oh, well, it's just a matter of who would win in a fight, Mr. T or Chuck Norris. And the soundboard right on cue goes, I ain't afraid of nothing. And everyone goes, oh shit, oh snap, it's on like Donkey Kong. I think that's the best part about it, that episode, is that the soundboard is right on cue. Like, it's never delayed in any way, shape, or form. So I always wondered who was actually controlling it. Like, I don't know. But it was like, oh, I died. It was right on cue, and it was... It made it seem like he really was there, despite from the fact that it was obviously a soundboard, but it was pretty fast. And I found it so fucking funny. Like, it was the funniest fucking thing ever. And at one point, like, Mr. T, because it's soundboard, like, it's the same sounds over and over again, so they really kind of kept repeating a lot of them. And, like, 40 minutes in, Mr. T says, like, something that's the same thing the third time or something. And Chris Roper just goes, I'm going to start ignoring you now. Everyone goes, well, oh, no, you don't ignore Mr. T. Love that episode. There's also, I also love the episode, I need another long-range weapon. I also love the episode where... Greg is gone, and he acts like he calls the guys while he's like away, and the guys pick up and the phone, and Greg's just like, I'm in the future. They're like, oh my god, the future, what, where are you? And he's like, I don't know, I'm in a limo, there's a screen on it. And they're like, oh, what's going on? And they're like, oh, I can see they've just released Home. Home is out. They all started laughing because back then it was a huge running joke that PlayStation Home was taking forever to release. Because it was. The thing was in beta for how many years, and now it's finally ending. And it's pretty much ending in beta, I guess you could say. But anyway, that was the joke was like, oh, I can finally see Home. They're like, oh my god. And then at one point, Greg was like, I can see Jack Tretton. He has a PlayStation 5. And they're like, oh my god, a PlayStation 5. Greg, what does it look like? He's like, it looks a lot like a Wii. Everyone started bursting out laughing. Oh, good stuff. If you don't listen to Podcast Beyond, you really should listen to it. Which is, of course, IGN's PlayStation podcast, which has been running for like 5 years. Also, I keep dying like a lot in the same area. And we're pretty much at the end of this Let's Play, to be honest. So, thank you already for watching. I'll see you all in part 5 of Uncharted, Drake's Fortune.